Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Today we're going to be talking about our lips. I feel like a really overlooked part of our face because it's part of our face and we should take care of... What? And we should give them the extra attention they deserve. They do so much, you know? But before I share some of my favorite lip products with you, we have a quick word from today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes to help inspire you and to help you find new interests, develop existing skills, get creative, and even if you just want something to do during lockdown. Working from home for the last 2 years has been amazing, and I'll be forever grateful. But especially during lockdown with nowhere to go, you find yourself getting a little bit... lazy, dare I say? I feel like I have no real work structure anymore. So I've been checking out Thomas Frank's Productivity for Creatives. That's not only been helping me get back into a workplace frame of mind, but also restructuring and generally structuring what a general work day will look like for me in order to help me kind of get back into the right working frame of mind and get out of this kind of like work funk I've been in. It's also helped me realize that I should delegate more tasks to my team so that I don't experience burnout, which a lot of creatives have. So whether you are new to being a full-time creator or you just kind of want to regroup, get everything back on working track. As a full-time creator, this is a course that you should definitely check out. You can sign up to Skillshare via the link in the description box down below. The first 1,000 people to sign up via the link in the description box will get a free trial of a Skillshare premium membership. And then after that, it's around £10 a month. So definitely check it out. I know a lot of you have been loving it. I've been loving it as well. Feed your creativity, you know? So today I'm going to share my daily lip routine. Yes, I do have a daily lip routine. Share a few tips and also some of my favorite products, but even ways you can use the products you already have to take better care of your lips. So first of all, let's start off with the difference between the skin on the rest of our face compared to the skin on our lips. It's very simple, really. The skin on our lips is a lot thinner than the rest of our face. The skin on our lips is around 3 to 5 cell layers thick, whilst the skin on our face can be up to 16 cell layers thick, so quite the difference. And that's why they're pink, because you can see all the blood vessels underneath. They also don't have sebaceous glands. Can you imagine lips with pores? It'll be horrible. But what that means is that our lips obviously don't produce the natural oils and sebum that the rest of our skin does, meaning saliva is kind of really the only moisture they get sometimes. However, of course, saliva can dry out our lips. We'll talk about that in a bit. So in my opinion, we need to be doing a little bit more for our lips than just using a lip balm. Here's a few things not to do. Do not pick your lips. Do not pick your lips. They get cracked very, very easily. Super, super easily. They go dry super easily. And you get those little bits of like skin that you just want to pull off. But the thing is with those bits of skin, once you start pulling, they just keep going and going and your whole lip comes off, you know, and you're bleeding. Just do not pick them. I've seen a lot of people using really aggressive scrubs on their lips as well. Again, bearing in mind the skin on our lips is a lot thinner, you'd still want to be careful. For me personally, I still find coffee scrubs and sugar scrubs way too much for my lips, and I often end up cutting them or making them a little bit raw. For me, gentle exfoliation includes warming up my lips with a flannel, then just doing a very, very gentle little scrub over the top, super gentle. That's all I do, but I do have lip exfoliating products that I'll share with you in a bit. As I mentioned, do not lick your lips. This is gonna draw any moisture that is in our lips out and just make them so much drier. The thing is, you lick them, they feel good for like a second, right? And then they're dry again, so you lick them again. It's like a really vicious cycle. This is why, along with everything that I'm gonna tell you today, I have lip balms in every pocket, every room, like every jean pocket, you know? Because the moment I want to lick my lips, I will apply a lip balm. I'd rather walk around with shiny lips like this than be licking or biting my lips. Another thing to look out for is overuse of chapstick. A lot of people break out around their lips, and this could be for two different reasons. You will find that in chapsticks or more like medicated chapsticks, they like to put in things like menthol, peppermint, you know, to give you that kind of like tingly feeling, like something's doing something, but this can really irritate your lips. Chapstick can also be a little bit too heavy for around the lips, so you might want to ditch the chapstick for now, and I'm gonna share some more options. Let's talk about dark lips, because this is a comment I get a lot, and I don't have an issue with dark lips, because if you have dark lips, it's not detrimental to your health. A lot of people of color and black people will have darker lips. Sometimes it's genetic. So I do not feel like lightening your lips is something. You wouldn't lighten the rest of your skin because of genetics. Why would you lighten your lips? I don't necessarily see it as a bad thing. Personal opinion. Sunscreen for the lips is important. Again, It's on your face. It's part of your skin. It is very difficult to find a chapstick with SPF that doesn't look like chalk on your lips or that doesn't taste like plastic shit, you know? It's very, very difficult. I do have a chapstick that I'm going to show you that I'm not in love with, but SPF, like the rest of our face, we need it on our lips as well. So can you just use the products you use on your face on your lips? Yes. You can. Not your actives, unless it's been formulated for your lips. It's a whole different thing. The skin's, again, a lot thinner, could be a lot more sensitive there. So I wouldn't go putting retinols over your lips or like vitamin C's, you know, or exfoliating acids because it could be way too strong. So I'm going to share with you my daily lip routine using products that you probably already have, but then I'm going to share with you a few specialized lip products that I absolutely love and use daily. So an everyday lip routine looks like this. Any hydrating step within my normal skincare routine will go on my lips. I dampen my face between every hydrating step. I apply a toner, like a moisturizing hydrating toner, all over my face on my lips. Any hydrating serums go straight on my lips. Any moisturizing serums go on my lips. So now once we have those lips nicely hydrated, because you want to feed it hydration, because it's not doing it on its own. So you want to feed that. So after the hydrating toner, any moisturizer I use on my face will go on my lips as well. And then just like your skin, you want to make sure none of that is escaping by putting over an occlusive layer. This can be with a chapstick or plain old Vaseline. The product I'm using here from Glow Recipe actually has exfoliants in, chemical exfoliants. So this chapstick has AHAs and we have malic acid and tartaric acid. And we have a little bit of ascorbic acid in this particular lip balm as well. So it's something nice to use like twice a day, morning and night. Very, very gentle, formulated for your lips. I enjoy this. It gives like a nice little pinky tint as well. At night, you might want to use something a little bit heavier. I'm using the M Cosmetics Clear Quartz Lip Cushion Nourishing Balm. This is just like a fancier lip balm, really, but it gives again this nice like sheen and a real feel of protection. We actually have sodium hyaluronate and squalane in here, both skin identical ingredients. Sodium hyaluronate to help bring some hydration into those lips, and then squalane as well. Again, a skin identical ingredient is going to help lock everything in. It feels really nourishing without feeling heavy, and like, you know, Vaseline kind of has like this warmth to it, does it? Yeah, this kind of like kind of feel to it. This the M Cosmetics product is really, really super, super light. And that's it, really. Hydrate your lips, then lock it in. You can use the most basic chapstick to lock everything in because it's pretty much a petroleum base anyway. And it really is that simple. Do that morning and night. And as long as you stick to that, really, you're going to be absolutely fine. Two products that I have literally by my bed and use every night is by the brand View 92. And with this, you get the Redual Lip Toner and you also get the Multi Lip Milk. Now, I love this because this is basically a toner for your lips. So I'm gonna show you, it comes in like this little tiny, really cute little pipette. Look at that, can you see that? You can. And every night I just put one tiny drop on my finger and then apply to the lips, and you can see how instantly hydrating that one tiny drop is. I'd be careful not to go around like the edges on my lips with all my lip products because I use them daily and quite often. And as I mentioned, it's quite easy to break out for me around there. I just feel like there's so much power in that one little drop, so much hydration in that one little drop. And then you could use the milk to kind of lock that all in. So literally, I the tiniest bit, I've had this for such a long time now. I usually do one lip and then just do that. Covers both lips. I feel like I'm gonna have these products forever because they just last so, so long. Another product I love as well as just normal Vaseline is the glossierbalm.com. I've always called this a fancier Vaseline. They come in different colors, different flavors. Yes, I will lick my lips and taste them. Also, the Milk Makeup Melatonin Overnight Lip Mask is one of my favorite lip masks. Again, it's thick enough to kind of give you that nice occlusive layer, but it's not too heavy and overbearing on the lips where you feel like you're suffocating, like your lips are sticking together. So I've got these SPF lip balms from Supergoop, and you know what? They're fine. They're absolutely fine. They don't give you a nice sheen. They don't give you nice gloss. Do they protect your lips? Yes. Do they taste like plastic? Absolutely. But you know, it's important to protect your lips. You can go over this with like a glossier lip product if you want to, as long as it's not too oily, more of like a makeup based lip product, I suppose. Love those products so, so much. But again, I'll repeat, hydrating toner, moisturizer over the lips, lip balm, you'll be absolutely fine. So really, lips isn't all that extra effort. You just kind of do what you do on your face, but on your lips with one extra product. But there we go, it's that simple. Lip care really is that simple. If you want some more skincare tips, tricks, etc., check out these videos here. If you want some general light entertainment, I don't know, while you tidy the house, watch these videos here, and I'll see you over there.